وثلاثة أيام بلياليها للمسافر.
And as for the person who is traveling, then 3 days and nights.
72 ساعة.
72 hours.
نعم. طيب نعتبر أن هذا الأخ أتى بالشروط شروط لبس الجوربين.
So let's say now this brother, he has fulfilled the conditions of wearing socks, fabric socks.
على طهارة كاملة بأن غسل رجلين مثلا مع صلاة المغرب.
So for example, at the time of the prayer of Maghrib, he performed his full wudu, including washing his feet, and then he wore his socks.
طاهرة.
And the socks were both pure.
ساتر الغالب العضو.
And it covers most of the foot.
وهذا في الحدث الأصغر.
And he's only broken his wudu due to the minor impurity, not the major impurity.
وفي الوقت لأنه لم يمضي على المسح شيء أصلا.
And within the time period, meaning within those 24 hours.
فكيف يمسح؟
So then, how does he wipe over his sock?
يمسح بأن يمسح على اليمنى واليسرى في وقت واحد على الظاهر فقط دون الباطن.
So he wets his hands. And then he wipes over
فقط.
His right foot with his right hand and his left foot with his left hand at the same time, and only on the top of the foot, not the bottom, just the top.
نعم. دون أن يمسح على الساق.
And that's without wiping over his shin, the shin bone.
أو يمسح أولا على اليمنى باليمنى ثم على اليسرى باليسرى.
هذا يجوز.
نعم.
Or it's permissible for him to wipe over his right foot first with his right hand and then after the left foot with his left hand.
وإذا كان لبس الجوربين على غير طهارة.
And let's say if he had worn the socks but he wasn't upon purity.
فماذا يصنع؟ يغسل.
So what should he do? Then he takes his socks off and he washes them.
يغسل الرجلين إلى الكعبين.
He washes his feet up until and including his ankles.
يعني يستوعب الكعبين.
Meaning includes that he washes his ankle as well.
هل يغسل الساق؟
Does he wash his shin?
لا.
No.
يخلل بين أصابع الرجلين بخنصر.
And he separates between the toes of his feet with his small finger.
يعني يتحقق من وصول الماء ما بين الأصابع لأنه في الغالب أصابع الرجلين متلاصقة.
Meaning that he has to make sure that water reaches between his toes as well.
خنصر. أي نعم.
It's using his small finger.
نعم. خلاص يا طيب. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: ويل للأعقاب من النار.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said:
ويل للأعقاب من النار. ويل.
He said: woe. He said: woe or a type of threat or punishment.
الأعقاب يعني آخر شيء من الرجل، عقب الرجل، العقب.
He said, woe or a threat of punishment be upon the ankle from the fire.
لأنه في الغالب أنه لا يأتيه الماء.
Because most often water doesn't cover it.
نعم.
Yes, sorry, as the brother mentioned, the heel, not the ankle, the heel.
نعم. طيب. بعد هذا عندما يغسل اليمنى ثم يغسل اليسرى يقول الدعاء الوارد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So after he has finished washing his right foot and his left foot, then he says the supplication which was narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل وضوء هذا الأخ صحيح أو باطل؟
So now the conclusion of this brother, is it correct, acceptable, or is it incorrect and invalid?
من يقول لي؟
Who will say?
هل وضوء هذا الأخ صحيح أم باطل؟
Is the ablution of this brother now, is it correct or incorrect?
نعم. باطل. لماذا؟ طيب اعتبر انه غسل اليمنى ثم غسل اليسرى هل الوضوء صحيح
ام لا؟ Let's say that he's washed his right foot and his left foot.
نعم صحيح.
It's correct.
نعم. لماذا بعض؟
Some say it's not wet.
غسل الوجه.
It's not wet anymore.
غسل الوجه. الله يفتح عليك. نعم. لم يحقق فرض من فروض الوضوء وهو الموالاة لأنه كان يفصل فصل يسير. الآن الوجه قد جف، حتى اليدين قد جفت. هذا أمر. الأمر الثاني خلل عند الأخ. ما هو؟ إذا نوى الآن الوضوء فوضوءه صحيح، وإن نوى التعليم فقط فوضوءه باطل ويجب جرى على التعليم ما شاء الله لنا وله الإخلاص والقبول يا رب.
So, as a brother mentioned, Allah bless him, that his wudu isn't correct. It's invalid, it's not accepted. Why? Because of two reasons. Number one, we mentioned that from the conditions of the ablution of the wudu is that each body part, each limb is washed continuously, such that when he reaches the next limb, the first limb doesn't become dry. And as you can see from the brother, his face is dry and now he's washing his feet. And therefore his wudu isn't correct. The second reason why the ablution isn't correct and it's invalid is because his intention. He didn't make the intention that he was performing wudu. Rather, his intention was that he was teaching the people. So therefore, his wudu isn't correct. However, his intention and his act of teaching the people, this is what he's voted on. And we ask Allah for sincerity and they accept the salamas.
Safat al-tayammum.
The description of performing a tayammum.
التيمم يكون
التيمم is
عند عدم الماء
is due to a lack of water
أو وجود ماء لكن لا يقدر على استعمال الماء
or if the water is present however he's not able to use the water
برد شديد
or for example due to severe cold
أو لديه مثلا مرض
or for example he is ill and therefore can't use the water.
حمى مثلا.
For example he has a fever.
طيب. كيف يتيمم؟
How does a person perform a tayammum? He makes an intention.
بقلبه.
In his heart.
ولا يتلفظ باللسان.
And he doesn't say upon his tongue.
ثم يسمي.
And then he mentions the name of Allah, بسم الله.
ثم يضرب ضربة واحدة بباطن كفيه.
And then he places the palm, his palms, either inside of his hand, onto the ground once. He places his hands once on the ground of the earth. Whether that is sand
أو طين
أو clay.
مع الماء يعني في شيء من الماء طين مع الرمل. طيب أو حصى
or small stones or small pebbles
أو صخرة
or a large stone. A rock or a boulder.
ضربة واحدة فقط.
Just once. Once he places his hands on those things.
ثم يمسح ظاهر الوجه دون تخليل.
And then he wipes over that which is apparent from his face without separating the strands of his beard.
ثم ظاهر الكف اليمنى ثم ظاهر الكف اليسرى.
And then the top of his right hand and then the top of his left hand.
ينوي.
So he makes an intention.
يسمي.
He says Bismillah, he mentions the name of Allah.
ضربة واحدة.
He hits those things, the ground or the dust or the soil, one time.
ثم يمسح على وجهه.
And then he wipes over his face.
وظاهر اليمنى ثم ظاهر اليسرى بدون تخليل الأصابع.
And then the top of his right hand and the top of his left hand without separating between the fingers.
بسم الله.
بسم الله.
ضربة واحدة. لا لا. هكذا بس.
Just wipe over once.
الحمد لله. تعيد. ينوي ويسمي اضرب الحمد لله رب العالمين طيب يبقى معنا صفة الاغتسال يصبر علينا
So the only thing that's left now is the way the description of forming ghusl and even though the time has come just be patient for a short while
الاغتسال اما ان يكون اغتسال مجزئ او اغتسال كامل
So there's two types of ghusl a ghusl which is sufficient and a ghusl which is the most perfect and complete.
نعم. الاغتسال الكامل واغتسال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the most perfect way and the most complete way of performing ghusl is like the way of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ومستحب أعلى من اغتسال المسلم.
And this is recommended and it's higher in degree than that which is just sufficient, the minimum amount of ghusl.
طيب. الاغتسال المسلم.
So what is sufficient in terms of the minimum amount of ghusl that you have to do?
أن ينوي بقلبه.
That you have an intention in your heart.
ثم يسمي.
And then you say Bismillah, you mention the name of Allah.
ويعمم جميع البدن بالماء.
And then he covers all of his body in water. Water reaches all the parts of his body.
وما تحت الشعور الخفيفة والكثيفة يعني يتحقق من دخول الماء إلى أصل وصول الماء إلى أصل البشرة.
And he also makes sure that the water, it reaches all the parts of his body, meaning even his skin under his hair and his beard, make sure that water reaches the skin. And this includes madmada, rinsing your mouth and rinsing your nostrils or your nose.
And yanawi.
So a person makes an intention.
Yusammi.
He mentions the name of Allah by saying Bismillah.
يعمم جميع البدن بالماء وما تحت الشعور الخفيف والكثيف.
He makes sure that water has reached every single part of his body, including that which is the skin, which is under the hair, whether it's light or whether it's heavy. Where you've got a lot of hair, a little amount of hair, make sure the water reaches it.
مع المضمضة والاستنشاق.
And this includes rinsing the mouth and استنشاق, rinsing the nose and nostrils.
طيب الاغتسال المستحب أعلى اغتسال واغتسال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And now the most complete and recommended and perfect way of performing iqtisal al-ghusl, the ghusl of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
يغسل أولاً الفرجين.
The first thing is he washes his private parts.
ثم يغسل اليدين إذا كان يعني في الفرجين شيء من الأوساخ وكذا بالصابون.
And then if there was some dirt in his private parts, then he washes his hands with soap.
أو بأي شيء من المنظفات سواء الصابون أو غير الصابون.
Or anything that will remove those impurities, anything that you need to wipe, any type of liquid, anything that will remove the impurities.
ثم يبدأ يتوضأ وضوء للصلاة.
And then he performs his ablution, the wudu that he would make for the prayer, his normal wudu.
يتمضمض ويستنشق ويستنثر ويغسل الوجه مع التخليل هنا للحية خفيفة وكثيفة. يغسل اليد اليمنى.
So now, for example, washing his hands, his face, also separating the strands of his beard and his hair. For you know, runs of water there. Washing the right hand, the left arm.
والرأس هنا يكون غسل لا مسح حتى يتحقق وصول الماء إلى أصل البشر.
And now here, when it comes to wiping the head, he doesn't wipe the head. He makes sure he washes the head. So he makes sure the water reaches his head, the skin beneath his head.
فإذا انتهى من الرأس مع الأذنين.
So if he has finished washing his head and the ears.
يبقى هنا في الوضوء غسل الرجلين.
The only thing that's now left from the ablution is washing his feet.
لا يغسل الرجلين.
But he doesn't wash his feet.
يغسل الشق الأيمن كاملا.
He now washes the right side of his body, all of it.
الشق الأيمن كاملا. ثم الشق الأيسر.
And then the left hand side of his body.
ثم يغسل الرجلين.
And then he washes his feet.
مرة أخرى.
So another time.
يغسل الفرجين.
Number one, he washes his private parts.
توضأ وضوء للصلاة.
And then after cleaning his hands, if there's any impurities, he makes his ablution for the prayer like he does for the prayer.
وبعد أن انتهى من رأسه.
But he washes his head, and if he's finished, once he's finished washing his head.
غسل لا مسح.
Are you washing and not wiping over like a normal wudu?
يغسل الشق الأيمن كاملا.
And then he washes or he runs water over the right side of his body.
ثم الأيسر كاملا.
And then the left side of his body, all of the left side.
ثم يغسل الرجلين.
And then he washes his feet.
إذا اغتسل هذا الغسل سواء كان الغسل المستحب او المجزئ يصح ان يصلي فيه مع انه في الاغتسال المجزئ لم يتوضا لكن الاغتسال اعلى من الوضوء.
So if a person has done this type of ghusl, either ghusl which is recommended and it's the complete perfect ghusl which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do, then he can perform any prayer and he can do any action of worship. If however a person doesn't perform this perfect, complete, recommended ghusl, however he makes the minimum amount of ghusl mean that water reaches all of his parts of the body, then still he can do any prayer, even though he hasn't performed ablution, but the minimum level of ghusl, it covers and it's more than the ablution.
Wallahu a'lam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.